गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स रिएक्शन विद ऑक्सीजन. व्हेन इट इज रिएक्टिंग, मेटल्स रिएक्टिंग विद ऑक्सीजन टू फॉर्म मेटल ऑक्साइड्स, करस्पॉन्डिंग मेटल ऑक्साइड. फॉर सपोज इफ वी टेक द आयन ऑक्सीजन मीन्स आयन ऑक्साइड विल बी फॉर्म Fe2O3. इफ वी टेक द मैग्नीशियम ऑक्सीजन मीन्स मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड विल बी फॉर्म. ओके, दिस इज अ रिएक्शन मेटल रिएक्शन विद ऑक्सीजन. एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द नॉन मेटल्स रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन, हाउ नॉन मेटल्स आर रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन. रिएक्शन ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स. रिएक्शन ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स विथ ऑक्सीजन. विथ ऑक्सीजन. ओके, सो बिफोर दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटल्स विथ ऑक्सीजन. When metal is reacting with oxygen to form metal oxides, that metal oxides are basic in nature. Metal oxides are basic in nature. Next, what about the non-metal oxides? Okay, by the activity we have to understand about the non-metal oxides reaction with non-metal react with oxygen. Okay, in the activity we have to take a small amount of powder sulfur. We have to take the small amount of sulfur powder. Sulfur is a non-metal. Okay. Small amount of sulfur we have to take in a deflagrating spoon. Deflagrating spoon means what? Here in the diagram, page number 47, they given the deflagrating spoon. Just a spoon type is there. In that we have to take the small amount of sulfur, and we can heat. We have to take the sulfur and we can heat. If deflagrating spoon is not available, means you may take a metallic cap. With metallic cap also we have to do this activity. Okay, deflagrating spoon is not available means we have to take the metallic cap. Just we have to take the any metallic cap and we can improvise the deflagrating spoon into the wire. Okay, metallic cap of any bottle and wrap a metallic wire around it and give it the shape of. Okay, if deflagrating spoon is not available means you may take a metallic cap of any bottle metallic cap we have to take and wrap a metallic wire around it, then it is also act as a deflagrating spoon. Okay, as soon as sulfur starts burning, when we are heating the sulfur, it is burning. Introduce the spoon into a gas jar or glass tumbler. When it is burning in presence of heat, we have to introduce that in gas jar or glass tumbler. We have to take the one tumbler and we have to introduce them and cover the tumbler with a lid to ensure that the gas produced does not escape. Okay, so when it is that sulfur is burning, immediately we have to keep in the glass tumbler and it is filled with lid. Okay, the cover with the tumbler with a lid. Why we are cover? Because of the gas produced does not escape. When it is burning, it will be produced the gas. That's why that gas will be escape. That's why we can cover the lid. Remove the spoon after some time, add a small quantity of water into the tumbler and quickly replace the lid. Shake the tumbler well and check the solution with red and blue litmus paper. Okay, when we are check the with litmus paper that solution, first what we have to do, we have to take the sulfur powder in a deflagrating spoon. If deflagrating spoon is not available means we have to take the any metal lid cap and covered with wire. Okay, so after that we have to heat that powder and it will be start the burning. When it is burning, we have to introduce into the gas jar. After that we have to cover with the lid. After that gas will be evolved, that gas not escaped. When we are covered with lid, it is not escaped. So after that we have to add some water and dissolve that gas into the solution. You have to check that, finally you have to check that solution with the litmus paper. Okay, in this activity what we have to understand, the name of the product formed in the reaction is sulfur. When sulfur is reacting with oxygen is sulfur dioxide gas. Name of the product formed in the reaction is of sulfur and oxygen is sulfur dioxide gas. When sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water, sulfurous acid is formed. When we have to write that reaction, the name of the product formed in the reaction, the name of the product formed in the reaction formed in the reaction of sulfur. Here we are taking the sulfur, and in presence of air we are burning. Okay, sulfur and air means oxygen. Sulfur in presence of oxygen, it is burning. Is what is the product? Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide gas is formed. Okay, the name of the product formed in the reaction of sulfur and oxygen is sulfur dioxide. When sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water, after that we are dissolving in water, when sulfur dioxide formula SO2. SO2 is a sulfur dioxide. Okay, when sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water, when sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water to form sulfurous acid, sulfurous acid will be formed. Okay, sulfurous acid is formed. So what is the reaction? How can we write this reaction? First, sulfur is reacting with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. Okay, sulfur is reacting with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide, and then after this sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water to form sulfurous acid. Sulfur dioxide formula SO2 is reacted with dissolving in water. Okay, this is a sulfur dioxide, this is the water, and it will be formed sulfurous acid. What is the formula of sulfurous acid? S2SO3. It will be formed sulfurous acid. The sulfurous acid turns blue litmus paper to red. Generally, oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. Next point, the sulfurous acid turns blue litmus paper to red. Sulfurous acid formula H2SO3. The sulfurous acid H2SO3 sulfurous acid turns blue litmus paper to red. Okay, the sulfurous acid turns blue litmus paper to red. Generally, oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. Which nature? Acidic in nature. In the last class, we are discussing about the metal oxides. Oxides of metal is a basic in nature. Oxides of non-metal is a acidic in nature. Okay, don't forget, this is an important word. Metal oxides are basic in nature, non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Okay, next one, reaction with water. This is a non-metal reactions. Non-metal react with oxygen. Before that, non-metal react with oxygen. Now, reaction with water. Okay, before going to the reaction with water, in the page number 48, they given the table metal and non-metal in acids and bases. Okay, once you have to check the, they given one example, calcium hydroxide. Calcium is a metal. You have to take the bases and acids, and you in that you have to identify which is the metal, which is the non-metal. For suppose sulfuric acid is there, nitric acid is there. Okay, so you have to take the sulfuric acid. Sulfur is a non-metal. Nitric acid, nitrogen is a non-metal. Nitric acid formula HNO3. Okay, calcium hydroxide is there, sodium hydroxide is there. Calcium hydroxide, which is a metal? Calcium is a metal. You have to identify metal. You have to take the any acid and base, and in that you have to identify, the which is the acid, which is the, sorry, which is the metal and which is the non-metal. Okay, in sodium hydroxide, which is a metal? Sodium is a metal. Calcium hydroxide, calcium is a metal. Okay, magnesium hydroxide, magnesium is a metal. You have to take the examples and identify metal and non-metal. Okay, acids and bases you have to take. And reaction with water. In the reaction with water, you have to take the, by the example, by the activity we have to understand the metal and non-metal react with water. Okay, sodium metal is very reactive. Already we know the, we did the practical in lab also. Sodium metal is very reactive. It reacts vigorously with oxygen and water. A lot of heat is generated in the reaction. It is therefore stored in kerosene. That's why we are stored in kerosene. Non-metal, metals and non-metal reaction with water. How that metals and non-metals react with water? Here, sodium is a highly reactive metal. Sodium metal is very reactive. Sodium metal is very reactive. It react vigorously. It react vigorously with oxygen and water. With oxygen and water. A lot of heat is generated in the reaction. So that's why we can store it in kerosene. Sodium metal is stored in kerosene. Okay, why we are store the metal in kerosene? Sodium metal is stored in kerosene because of its highly reactive. Sodium metal is very reactive. It react vigorously with oxygen and water. A lot of heat is generated in the reaction. So when sodium is reacting with water, it will be catch the fire. That's why we can store it in the kerosene. Okay. And metal and non-metal reactivity with water. By the activity we have to understand. In that activity we have to take a 250 ml beaker or glass tumbler, fill off with the water, and now carefully cut a small piece of sodium metal and dry it using filter paper and wrap it in a small piece of cotton. Put the sodium piece wrapped cotton into the beaker. Observe carefully what happened when that sodium metal is wrapped into the water. What happened? It will be react with water and produce the heat and fire will be catches that. Reaction stops, touch the beaker. What do you feel? Has the beaker become hot? Test the solution with red and blue litmus papers. Is the solution is acidic or basic? Okay. So when we are wrap the piece of sodium into the beaker, what will happen? It is that once you have to try to touch the that beaker, it will become hot. We have to feel it is a hot. Has the beaker become hot? Test the solution with the red and blue litmus papers. Then we have to identify that solution is a acidic or basic. Okay. When metal react with water, means metal oxides will be formed. Metal oxide means it is a basic nature or a acidic nature. Already we are metal oxides are basic in nature. Okay. We can observe that sodium reacts vigorously with water. Some other metals do not. Because of, for example, iron react with water slowly. Sodium is a metal and iron is a metal. But iron is react with water is slowly. Some of the metals react with vigorously and some of the metals react with slowly. Generally, non-metals do not react with water. Though they may be very reactive in air. But non-metals very reactive in air. Such non-metals are stored in water. For example, phosphorus. Phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. In metals, sodium is a highly reactive metal. In non-metals, which is a highly reactive non-metal? Phosphorus. That's why that phosphorus stored in water. Why we are storing in water? Because of it, reactivity will be decreased in water. Generally, non-metals do not react with water. That's why we are stored in the water. But here, metal is, sodium is a highly reactive metal. That's why we can store it in the kerosene. Okay, that is the difference. Now, in the reaction with water, we observe that sodium reactivates. Sodium reacts vigorously. Sodium reacts vigorously with water. Sodium reacts vigorously with water. Some other metals do not. Some other metals do not. Okay, do not do so. For example, iron. For example, iron reacts with water slowly. Iron reacts with water slowly. For example, iron reacts with water slowly. Generally, non-metals do not react with water. Generally, non-metals do not react with water. So they may be very reactive in air. They may be very reactive in air. Non-metals are slowly reactive with water. Generally, suppose if we have take the iron, it is react with water is very slowly. Generally, non-metal do not react with water. They may be reactive, very reactive in air. With the air, non-metals are reactive very fastly. Such non-metals are stored in water. The type of non-metals we can store in water. Why? Because the non-metals do not react with water. That's why we can store it in the water. Such non-metals are stored in water. For example, phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. Phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. It catches fire if exposed to air. It catches fire. If exposed to air. Okay. Phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. It catches fire if exposed to air. To prevent the contact of phosphorus with atmospheric oxygen, it is stored in water. To prevent the contact of phosphorus with atmospheric air, with atmospheric oxygen, it is stored in water. Okay, it is stored in water. So this is about the reaction with water. Metals and non-metals react to reaction with water. Simply here, when metal is reacting with water, it is of fastly react with water and they produce the heat. They will catch the fire. Generally, non-metals do not react with water. So that's why the highly reactive non-metal we can store it in the water. For example, phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. It catches fire if exposed to air. So that's why to prevent the contact of phosphorus with atmospheric oxygen, it is stored in the water. In the metal, sodium is a highly reactive metal. So we can store it in the kerosene. In the non-metal, phosphorus is a highly reactive non-metal. That's why we can store it in the water. So in the water, it does not react with water, phosphorus. But it is react with air. Air means oxygen. Okay, that is the difference. Okay, remaining we can discuss in the next class. Thank you.